Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Russell Temple CME Church. We thank you for joining us this morning. My name is Reverend Daniel Nguyen Jr. I'll be your worship leader for today. We are located in Alexandria, Virginia. This is a call to worship. Sit back, and if you hear something that might bless you, enjoy the service. No accidents you join us today. And we're grateful that you're here to hear our extraordinary and anointing pastor, Pastor Kevin Agee. Okay, I welcome you and listen to our song, our first song by our choir. This is the day that the Lord has made. Thank you for joining us.
Today, our hymn of praise is going to be, "This is the day that the Lord has made." Come on and join in with us. As we say,
some praise today. We thank you again for joining us here at Russell Temple. Next, we will have an invocation by exhorter Elaine Sherman, and then we have scripture by Reverend Daniel Nguyen. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. If we can just bow our heads. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for always having room for us when sometimes we don't have room for you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for being omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent, Lord. Lord, we ask today that you usher your spirit into this place, Lord. Lord, we ask that you allow something be said or heard to bring us closer to you, Lord. Lord, we ask that you be with our pastor as he bring forth the word today. For this is our prayer in your precious son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. So today, if you would turn with me for a scripture reading on today, Philippians 4 through 9. Philippians 4 through 9. And the second scripture I would like for you to turn with me is 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 to 18. 5, 16 to 18. Philippians 4 through 9. I'm reading from the NIV. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. 8. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, what is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 to 18. Sorry. 1 Thessalonians 5:16 to 18. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Amen, amen, and amen. The word is already blessed. Next, we will have a song by choir. Thank you.
In Revelation 15:3, the good book says, and they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are thy works, Lord God Almighty, just and true are thy ways, thou kings of saints. God has done marvelous things in your life. Come and sing along with us.
You've done such a marvelous thing. Yeah.
For you just this week. Think about the marvelous things that God has blessed you with and things that is happening in your life. You need to praise the Lord and give him all the praise today, everyone. And right there where you're sitting, right there where you're standing. Next, we'll have an offering appeal from one of our steward board members, then a selection from our amazing choir, and then we'll hear from our exceptional anointing pastor, Pastor Kevin Agee. Sit back and give him the praise, y'all. And I'm Reverend Daniel Wynn, and I'm grateful that I served as your worship leader on this day. And everyone have a blessed week.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is now time for offering. Time to give back a portion to God of what he has given to us. We are asking if you can please begin paying on your big K, and please specify on your envelope what you are paying. As you know, there are several ways to pay your tithes and offerings. We have the online Givelify, Cash, and PayPal. You can mail it to the church at Russell Temple CME Church, 507 North Alfred Street, Alexandria, Virginia, 22314. Or you can drop it off at the church at 507 North Alfred Street. And last of all, you can contact one of the steward board members, and they will be glad to assist you. Thank you, and have a blessed day.
Rejoice, 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 rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. That's what the word is all about for today. Amen. Not real theologically deep, not real complicated. We just want to talk for a few minutes about rejoicing. Amen. The contemporary choir started us out with that beautiful praise song based upon Psalm 118:24. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Somebody ought to shout rejoice right where you are. I see somebody already type rejoice in the chat. Amen. Rejoice. Hallelujah. You heard the scripture read for your hearing. I actually combined two short passages. Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 through 9 is actually the lectionary epistle reading for today, and coupled with 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. That's my addition. I want to focus your attention at this time on two short passages of scripture a total of four verses, but they're real short. They're basically two sentences, amen? Two sentences, but four verses, amen? I want to focus your attention on Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. Then I focus your attention on 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18. Three verses in one sentence. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Our thought for today, my brothers and my sisters, is very simply, rejoice always. Rejoice always. Let us pray. Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. Let my soul look up with a steadfast hope and my will be lost in thine. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Now may the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Rejoice always. When we have faith, we can rejoice regardless of our circumstances. I'm grateful that the tech team had them play. I figured the version by Israel, the New Breed, would be uplifted. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. But strangely enough, I was actually a seminary student, and a classmate was a leading chap. And it was in seminary chapel that I first heard a little song. And I think there's some variations where this is just a refrain. But in this instance, when I first heard it in chapel, this was the whole song. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. I just want to share the exhortation and encouragement of this word to rejoice always. I've become a convert in my faith journey. I've become a convert to the school of thought that makes a distinction between happiness and joy. And I love the distinction between happiness and joy. Happiness is based upon circumstances. Amen. Joy is dependent upon what's in your soul. You see, things have to be going right in order for me to be happy. But when, no matter how calamitous, no matter how chaotic things may be, when I have Jesus in my soul, I can have joy. Isn't that right? And so the fact of the matter is, when you're a person of faith, you can rejoice no matter what the circumstances. So beloved, I just want to encourage everybody to rejoice always, rejoice all the time. Some horrible things have happened this week. While we were down in Durham, North Carolina, at the minister's retreat, right a few miles down the road in East Raleigh, they had another mass shooting where five people were killed and a couple others critically wounded by a 15-year-old with an assault weapon. But even in the midst of that kind of craziness, we can rejoice. We have lunatics who are running for political office, but we can still rejoice. Amen. We got a lunatic of a former president who's broken almost every law there is. He's committed numerous felonies, and there's all types of evidence. And still, you have folk crazy enough to worship him as he was some kind of God. But in the midst of that, we can still rejoice. The Apostle Paul, in the letter to the Philippians and in the first letter to the Thessalonians, he says, rejoice always. In Philippians 4, he says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say, rejoice. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16, he simply says, rejoice always. And, you know, when you look at Paul's story, he's been through some stuff. Even if you think about the context for his writing, his letter to the Philippians, Paul's letter to the Philippians was one of the letters that he wrote while he was in prison. But even though he was in prison, he was able to rejoice. He was able to rejoice because despite him being in prison, the gospel was still being spread. And he understood that some folk were spreading the gospel just because they wanted to carry on the work of the Lord in his absence. And for that reason, it was easy for him to rejoice despite being in prison. But on the other hand, he also understood that some other folk were proclaiming the gospel, not because they just wanted to do the Lord's work, but just because they were envious and jealous of Paul. And they saw Paul's imprisonment as an opportunity for them to shine, for them to be on center stage, for them to be out front. But still, he was able to rejoice just because the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ was being spread. So he could send the message, rejoice always. And as you look at Paul's story, this is far from the only thing that he went through as an apostle for Jesus Christ. If you take a look when you have an opportunity at 2 Corinthians chapter 11, between verses 23 and 25, you'll see that Paul tells just a little bit of his story about suffering in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. He talks about having been in prison multiple times. He talks about having been flogged countless times. He talks about having received the 40 minus one stripes or the 40 minus one lashes or the 39 stripes or the 39 lashes five times. He talks about having been beaten with rods three times. He talks about having been shipwrecked and adrift at sea for a day and a night at least three times. But even in the midst of that, still this faithful servant of God is able to encourage the readers to rejoice always. Yes, my brothers and my sisters, we ought to follow the example of God's servant, the Apostle Paul, and we ought to ask the Spirit of the living God to help us to rejoice always. And as you look at the lectionary reading, Philippians 4, beginning at verse 4, you'll see that just between verses 4 and 7, there are three reasons why we can rejoice always if we have faith in our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. The first reason I submit to you that we can all rejoice always is that the Lord is near. Is there anybody here who knows that the Lord is near? Did not the psalmist say that the Lord is near to the brokenhearted and to the crushed in spirit? We can rejoice always because we know that the Lord is near. Number two, the second reason why I suggest to you this afternoon that we can rejoice always is that the Lord hears our prayers. In verse 6, Philippians 4:6 says, do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Is there anybody here who's been burdened down or stressed out or seems like you had, you know, some serious pain you were dealing with? And even though your problem was not necessarily solved immediately, when you went before God in prayer, you felt better. Is there anybody here who can testify, even if God didn't solve the problem right away, even if God didn't give you the answer to the prayer right away, when you were going through something, when your heart was heavy, when your mind was on overload, when you went before the Lord in prayer, as soon as you finished praying, you felt better? Can anybody testify to that this afternoon? Somebody ought to shout or type, hallelujah, God answers our prayers. Third and final reason why I suggest that as a person of faith, you can rejoice always is that the Lord's peace will guard your heart and your mind. I just love that seventh verse. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Because the Lord's peace will guard our hearts and our minds, we can all rejoice always. And as we look at this passage, even though the lectionary ends at verse 9, I want to call your attention to verses 10 through 13. That's an example of how Paul grew to a point in his faith journey where he was able to rejoice always, where he was able to rejoice regardless of the circumstances. He put his faith in action by being able to rejoice no matter what was going on. You've probably heard me mention a couple of times, and I like to remind folk, every now and then, we all like to talk about that 13th verse. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. But the fact of the matter is, you can't put that verse in its proper context if you don't think about verses 10 through 12. In that passage, the Apostle Paul says, I rejoice greatly now that I have at last, you have received your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned for me, but had no opportunity to show it. Not that I'm referring to being in need, for I've learned to be content with whatever I have. I know what it is to have little, and I know what it is to have plenty. In any and all circumstances, I've learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of having plenty and of being in need. Is there anybody here this afternoon who knows how to rejoice no matter what your circumstances? I believe that if we have faith, we can do like the Apostle Paul. We can rejoice when we're in need, and we can rejoice when we have plenty. We can rejoice when we're hungry, and we can rejoice when we're full. We can rejoice when we're sad, and we can rejoice when we're happy. We can rejoice when we're down in the depths of despair, and we can rejoice when we're high on emotion. We can rejoice when we're down in the valley, or we can rejoice when we've been exalted to the mountaintop. Is there anybody here this afternoon who has a Philippians 4 kind of faith where you can rejoice always? Is there anybody here who has a 1 Thessalonians 5 kind of faith where you can rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and give thanks in all circumstances, knowing that this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for us? My beloved, I believe that we all, as people of faith, ought to rejoice always. When I was a little boy growing up at Israel Metropolitan CME Church in Washington, D.C., on a regular basis, we used to sing an old hymn of the church that I don't hear much anymore, an old hymn of the church that was written by Edward H. Plumter in 1865. Rejoice, ye pure in heart, rejoice, give thanks and sing. Your festal banner wave on high, the cross of Christ your King. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Bright youth and snow-crowned age, strong men and maidens meek, raise high your free, exalting song, God's wondrous praises speak. Now, I believe the earliest translations of that second stanza actually read, bright youth and snow-crowned age, strong men and maidens fair, raise high your free, exalting song, God's wondrous praise declare. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. But I believe this next stanza here, I believe this sums up the message for today in terms of rejoice always. It says, yes, on through life's long path, still chanting as we go from youth to age, by night and day, in gladness and in woe. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Is there anybody here this afternoon who can rejoice both in gladness and in woe? Can you rejoice whether you're up or whether you're down or whether you're almost level to the ground? Can you rejoice whether times are good or bad, happy or sad? Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Rejoice always. Give God some praise.
Sing. Amen. Hallelujah. God is an awesome God. Jesus loves us all unconditionally. Isn't that right? Jesus made the ultimate sacrifice for our sins and the sins of the whole world. We want to take this opportunity to invite someone to give his or her life to Christ this afternoon. If you're not absolutely certain that your soul is saved and that your sins are forgiven, it's real easy. Sometimes we make things much more complicated than they need to be. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you will be saved. It's just that simple. If there's someone who wants to give his or her life to Christ this afternoon, we invite you to share with us. If you feel so moved, you can unmute and verbalize your desire. If you prefer to do something else, you can type either a private or public message in the chat if you're watching on Zoom. If you prefer a more personal means of communicating with the pastor, you may call or text me at 201-736-9107. My personal cell phone number, you can call or text me, 201-736-9107. Or you can send me a private message through the social media of your choice. I'm on Facebook, I'm on LinkedIn, Snapchat, Instagram, and my Twitter handle is Preaching Turf. All those other media is just Kevin H, plain and simple. Please feel free to reach out if you want to give your life to Christ. If you're already a part of the body of Christ, a part of the church, and you just want to recommit or rededicate your life to the Lord, or if you feel a calling on your life to preach or to exhort or to start a new ministry in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, you may communicate with me. Any of the means that I just named, same thing. Last but not least, my friends, if there's anyone watching or listening this afternoon who is in need of a church home, we would love to have you here at the Russell Temple Christian Methodist Episcopal Church in the heart of Old Town Alexandria, 507 North Alfred Street. Even though it'll be a little while longer before we get back in the physical building, even though we're still worshiping on Zoom electronically right now, make no mistake about it, the doors of the church stand wide open on the hinges of welcome. Is there one who will join the Christian church this afternoon? Is there one who will recommit or rededicate their life to the Lord this afternoon? Is there one who will give his or her life to Christ this afternoon? The doors of the church are open. My friends, as we prepare to bow down before God in prayer, as we go before the throne of grace, this afternoon, at the end of church school this morning, we received a prayer request. We want to lift up in prayer the family of, Nathan Foster, right? I thank you, the family of Nathan Foster, a good friend of the family of Sister Vanessa Green and family. He died very suddenly, unexpectedly, and we all know, how tragic and how traumatic that can be. So we just want to lift up his children, his family, his loved ones, all his friends. We'll lift up the family of Nathan Foster. Also, some of my colleagues had to miss our retreat yesterday because some of y'all may have read about it. I've seen folks about it, post about it on Facebook. There was also an article in the Christian Post and in some of the Memphis area newspapers. But there was a dynamic young pastor in the CME Church, Reverend Willie Boyd, of Greenwood CME Church in Memphis, Tennessee. He had a young wife and three small children, the youngest of which was 6 months old and had just been baptized. He had just baptized his youngest child a week before. He was tragically killed. One car accident, ran into a tree. 44 years old, gone on to the Lord. So I just want to lift up the family of Reverend Willie Boyd, the Greenwood CME Church family, and also lift up the many lives in the CME Church and in the city of Memphis that were touched by Reverend Willie Boyd and his life and his ministry. Last but not least, we want to lift up the families of all of those who were massacred in East Raleigh, North Carolina. And we want to pray God's healing upon the two victims who were wounded who remain in the hospital, one of whom is in critical condition. God is able, isn't that right? God is still our refuge and our strength. God is a very present help in the time of trouble. Let us bow for a word of prayer. Sweet hour prayer that calls me from a world of care and bids me at my Father's throne make all my wants and wishes known. In seasons of distress and grief, my soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's snare. By thy return, sweet hour prayer, thank you, Lord, for another new and beautiful day in your sight. Thank you, Lord, for another day that you have made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Lord God, we just pray that by the power of your Holy Spirit, that you will give your people a faith that allows us to rejoice always. Thank you, Lord, for encouraging us and exhorting us to rejoice always, to pray without ceasing, and to give thanks in all circumstances, knowing that this is your will for us in Christ Jesus. Lord God, I lift up all of our brothers and our sisters facing health challenges. I pray that you would lay your hand of healing upon them. Lord God, I pray your healing upon those who were wounded in the most recent mass shooting. Lord God, I pray your comfort, strength, and peace upon the families of all the victims who lost their lives in East Raleigh, North Carolina. And Lord God, we even lift up the family, friends, and loved ones of the perpetrator, 15-year-old, with an assault weapon. And oh Lord our God, we pray your comfort, strength, and peace upon the family of Reverend Willie Boyd. Lord God, we pray that you would keep his family, that you would keep his church family, that you would keep his brothers and sisters throughout the CME connection, the body of Christ, his neighbors in the city of Memphis. We pray that you would keep all who knew and loved him in your loving care. Lord God, we lift up the family of Brother Nathan Foster. We lift up his friends. We lift up his loved ones. We lift up all of those who were touched by his life and his legacy. And oh Lord our God, we pray your comfort, strength, and peace upon all of our brothers and our sisters who have suffered loss. Lord God, we continue to remember those who've been impacted by the hurricanes and tropical storms and other natural disasters in the United States and the Caribbean and other places in the world. And Lord God, we lift up all of our brothers and sisters continuing to be impacted by the COVID pandemic and the spread of monkeypox. Lord God, we lift up all in healthcare. Lord God, we lift up all first responders. Lord God, we lift up all of our brothers and our sisters, Lord God, knowing that all of your children stand in the need of prayer. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Incline thine ear to us and grant us thy peace. In the precious name of Jesus our Christ, we pray.
Amen. All right, all right. Put your hands together in this place. Change that cover from the end. here. Send the praise up. Throw your hands in the air and wave them from side to side. Cause he's here.
Amen. Hallelujah. Give God some praise. A few quick commercials just before the doxology and the benediction. First, we want to give God thanks and praise for those who led us in our worship. We give God praise for Reverend Wynn and Exhorter Sherman. Amen. To God be the glory. We give God praise for the ministry of the Contemporary Choir. Amen. And our director of music, Brother Larry Foster. Amen. Give God praise for our awesome tech team. Can we give God some glory? Amen. Praise God for each and every one of you. And you might notice that a number of us have on pink. Amen. The ladies are pretty in pink. The pastor's not pretty, but he has on pink. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now, I can't do like Michael Irvin. Now, I went morning in the hotel early in the morning in between the prayer call and the first meeting I had to go to, I was scrolling through the NFL channel. I saw Michael Irvin hell in his bright pink suit. Okay, I can't wear no pink suit. They had a pink shirt and pink tie. Now you've got on some socks with pink in them. I can't wear no pink pants, though. Amen, somebody. But all jokes aside, beloved, we're wearing pink in observance of breast cancer awareness and in solidarity with those who have battled and are battling breast cancer. And I know we have a number of breast cancer conquerors in our congregation. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. We have some breast cancer conquerors in our congregation. Amen. So I just want to encourage everyone, especially our ladies, you know, get your mammograms regularly. Amen. It's important, isn't that right? Early detection is imperative. Amen. And sometimes we have situations, I won't go into any details, but, you know, sometimes you have situations where, you know, abnormal cells can hide behind tissues. And, you know, and sometimes the GYN might see something on the screen. They might have to send the person for a 3D MRI so to be able to detect those cells. So, you know, cells can hide. Amen. So it's imperative of my sisters that you get your tests done on a regular basis. And not just the sisters, brothers, we can get breast cancer too, quiet as it's kept, amen? We can get breast cancer too. As a matter of fact, the great Richard Roundtree, the original Shaft, a man's man, Richard Roundtree, Shaft is a breast cancer conqueror, amen? So, beloved, we want to tend to our personal health. God made us stewards of everyone and everything he created. We are also stewards of our own health. So please, ma'am, and please, sir, get yourself checked out. Amen. Praise God. And let us continue in prayer for all who are battling breast cancer. And let us continue to give God glory for all who have conquered breast cancer. We pray that one day we'll be able to find a cure. Amen. Praise God. Want to give a special shout out to all of the Russell Temple Church family who are participating in the Step Alive Walkathon this afternoon. We give God thanks. We give God praise. I know Sister Dorothy Outlaw is walking, has raised a large sum of money already. Brother Mario Rowland, I know, is walking. Sister Doris Thorne is volunteering. And all others who are participating or have donated to the Step Alive Walkathon, we want to thank you for what you are doing. And when you get your t-shirts, you will see the name of Russell Temple CME Church on the roll, amen. As a member congregation, we are one of the sponsors. So you're gonna see your name. You may not see our name in lights, but you see your name on the t-shirt, amen. Praise the Lord. And in the literature publications from Alive. And thank you very much, Russell Temple, for your leadership in this ministry, amen. I see Sister Wanda said, got my t-shirt. Amen. Praise the Lord. We give God thanks and we give God praise for each and every one who thought it not robbery to donate and to participate. I didn't really have time to get down there time enough to walk, so I ain't even gonna try. You know, Lord forgive me, but I'm gonna watch the football game this afternoon. But I did donate. Amen. Also, amen. Praise God. Thank you so much, everyone. We appreciate your love and your support. Amen. This week, beloved church conference, so tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock, it's important, but we won't keep you all night. Amen. We'll do what we need to do, and we'll be done. Tuesday night, music ministry. Every member of every adult choir, hallelujah, every member of every adult choir who is available, all the adult leaders of the Little Buds, amen, we need you on a Tuesday evening. Brother Foster, it won't keep you long. I won't keep you long either, amen. But we need to gather together. And we give God thanks and praise for our music ministry, but we need to talk a little bit, and we'll do things as expediently as possible. You saw the slide again. Vote, vote, vote. The late, great John Lewis, a voting rights advocate, a grassroots organizer, a member of SNCC, civil rights leader, and legendary congressman, used to have a phrase where he talked about getting in good trouble. Amen. Tonight, the CME Church is having Good Trouble Sunday. This evening, you can either watch the live stream on the CME Church Facebook page, or there is a Zoom link, and Sister Louise already sent the email out to the entire congregation. And those of you who are on my district email list, y'all got it twice. But the Zoom information, the Zoom ID is 984-855-3-2228. And the password is CME2022, CME in all caps, amen. 984-855-3-2228 need some glasses. It says 653, not 8553. Read that too quick. 984-8653-2228. And numbers in the email. And the password is CME2022, all caps for CME in the password. Good Trouble Sunday. Tonight, 8 o'clock our time. It says 7 o'clock Central Time. But that's 8 o'clock our time on Zoom or on the CME Church Facebook page. We want to encourage our brothers and our sisters to organize to vote. This morning in between church, school, and our worship service, I listened to Howard University's Rankin Chapel broadcast on HUR. Last Sunday, Reverend Al Sharpton preached at the chapel. And in that sermon, he was talking about how the Supreme Court is hearing a case right now that could completely dismantle what's left of the Voting Rights Act. And he reminded us very poignantly, among other things, that people were killed because they had the audacity to try to vote and to organize folk to vote. Brothers and sisters, we need to vote. If our vote were not important, folk wouldn't be trying to work so hard to eliminate our right to vote. So we just want to encourage you to be a part of that. We thank you and we appreciate you. And last but not least, my beloved, this week in Bible study, we'll be finishing up the second chapter of the book of Acts, the story of the day of Pentecost. We started out talking about the Holy Spirit coming in the first 13 verses. Last week, we looked at Peter's sermon in verses 14 through 36. This week, we're going to focus on the growth of a vibrant church in Acts chapter 2, verses 37 through 47 this week in Bible study. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. Have a wonderful week in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Some of y'all I'll see Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and others on Saturday. God bless you. God keep you. Have a wonderful week in Jesus' name. Rejoice always. Amen. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be among you and remain with you always. Amen.